ventilators with the exception of a few, and they go out for service and things sometimes, and Mr. Vosper and the guy from the rental company will just come in here and take stuff. So we wanna make sure it doesn't have any of our supplies on it, cause these things are not cheap. So, some of the things that you have to get out every time we get vents out is the connectors for the air and the O2, and so you're just gonna screw these onto the hoses for O2. And the air. Word of caution, before I put this on, do not, either one, whether it's yellow or green, put it into the wall when it's not hooked up to a hose. Because if you do, what will happen? 50 PSI will come shooting out and you'll scream. And then I'll yell at you, not literally yell, but you'll still be screaming, trying to look at it, not knowing what to do, and you have to push the buttons down and take it out. Can't screw the hose on it while it's in there, so take it out. Always make sure they're hooked to the hose first. So when we're done at the end of class, you'll take those off and put them away in the room and leave it plugged in. I'll show you what goes in the bag as well. Other than that, everything else gets put away so that we have a very set way that it gets stored in here as well. And if they ever get sent out, then they just take this bag off. So these are gonna get plugged into the back. As we go into the ventilators more, I'll tell you why we need these specific sizes for meeting O2. And if you listen, you can hear it actually, hear that, that's the air. If it's not hooked up, you actually won't hear that at all, and it's a way to know that the O2 and the air tanks are not on, which I have to turn on when we first come in. So sometimes you guys are starting on them and I forgot to turn them on, so you can hear that. That's how we know they're plugged in. All the vents turn on in different places. Some are in the back, some are in the front. I'll show you this one in a minute. The other thing I want to show you that's specific to any ventilator is the humidifier systems. Not every one of our vents has a humidifier on it. This is basically just like a little hot plate with temperature controls. We want to maintain the temperature the same as body temperature so that the heat and humidity heat the airway for our patient. So we have two different kind of heaters, and they're basically two different universal kinds that exist out in the clinical setting. So there's one like this that's round. It has exactly what looks like a little hot plate on it. And there are chambers that look like these. So there's numerous bags on each ventilator. Some have two, some have one. Some have a round container like this, and some have a metal container like this one. Here. Both of them serve the same purpose. They just work on different humidifiers. This one works on this one, and this one I'm going to show you in a minute works on what's called a concha humidifier. What are you laughing at?
He's being a very good videographer.
Oh, okay. And that'll be a good video to watch while you're learning. So this, all you're going to do is push this down, and it'll slide into place like that. This cap here is really for storage, but in the clinic setting, you would just put this on here and leave it like that until you were ready to put it on a patient. What happens, and you don't use them here because we're not going to go through a million water bags for no reason, but this is an auto feed system. So the way this works is once it's in here and you're actually ready to put it on a patient, you're going to take this out and poke it into a bag, and then the water will just drain out into here all the time. That's auto feed. For our purposes, we're not going to poke it into the bag. I'm going to show you how to do everything but that. I think if you can run the vent, you can handle this part. While we're here in class, this is a source of a leak. So we're going to talk about troubleshooting and how, and you heard that a little bit in the presentations that we had last term. Ways to tell if there's a leak somewhere. These little holes at the end of this are a source of a leak. It won't pass your calibrations. It'll say that there's a leak somewhere if this is not capped off. So you're going to be having this down here like this. And then you're going to be raising your hand and telling me your calibration won't pass, and nothing's wrong, and I'm going to come over to the vent and I go, yeah, there is something wrong. And eventually you'll realize it's this. So in class, or when you're not using this on a patient, this has to be capped off, and it's as simple as just putting it in there, okay? It just comes up every time, and if you're testing in that and things like that are going on, you have to be able to troubleshoot it. Troubleshooting is a huge part of mechanical ventilation. So we're just going to let it sit on there for now, right now. So that's how this heater works, and then the water would just go into there. This one, it would be attached to the ventilator, of course, but for right now, I just have it over here. And this is called a concha system. And so if your preceptor ever tells you that they need a concha, this is what they're talking about. They need the water bottle to replace the concha. That's what we call it. So as you can see, this one's empty. You would just take this out, just like that. And there would always be a little bit of water left in here. So you turn it like this, clamp these off, and pull those out. And you could throw that away, get a new one, and then put it back in, and then poke it. Stab it with your little things here and unclamp it. And then it will automatically feed water down into here, which is like that one cylinder I showed you already. So these just slide in and out of here. This gets very hot on the inside, so if you take this out after it's been running, this will be hot. Be careful so you don't burn yourselves. And it'll just slide down like that. One there. One there. I want you guys to see that both of these have two ports on the top. Doesn't matter whether it's the round cylinder one or the round, this round plastic one over here. There's two ports. This one actually has an in and an out, I think, or it might be the other one. No, this one it doesn't matter. One of them it does, this one it does not. So you're gonna hook up hoses to those. You can hook them up into either one. And you have to learn how to use both of these humidifiers. So the reason I was telling you we don't have a humidifier for every ventilator is because doing this, taking this container and sliding it on there, any of you can do. So if you don't have a an actual heater on your vent, I'm gonna show you how to hook up the hoses, and you'll just hook them up to this and let them hang. Like it was sitting on one, but it's not. It's very lightweight. So if this wasn't sitting here, don't worry if you don't see one of these. You'll just hook it up and let it hang, which I'm going to show you how to do. Same for this cylinder one. If you don't have the heater actually on the ventilator, don't worry. Just take this, hook your hoses up to it, and let it hang. Because the only thing you would do clinically different is just put it right in the middle part. Okay? So you're learning how to hook up all the wires and the hoses is the hard part. Sliding it onto the heater, the hot plate is easy. So we only have a few of the actual heaters. Okay, so there are also two sets of wires that could be used. So that a lot of the things about mechanical ventilation are learning how things hook up and how to do them, and it doesn't matter if something looks different. Same thing's going to happen when we start talking about the ventilators. They all have the same features. They all do the same things. They just have different names, and their buttons are in different places. So I always relate a lot about this to driving a car because it's something you can all relate to. It doesn't matter. Once you learn how to drive a car, you can drive pretty much any car. Maybe you can't drive a stick shift if you didn't learn how to do that, but you can get in a Honda, a Toyota, a Chevy, whatever. You know you need to find the ignition, find the accelerator, turn the radio on, roll down the windows, and put your air conditioning on and things like that. Well, vents are the same way. It doesn't matter what name you call it, you have to find the different parts on the ventilator. We're gonna talk about where to set settings and where to set patient parameters and where to set alarms and how to turn it on. It doesn't matter what it looks like and it doesn't matter what it's called, it will still have all those same functions. So don't be incredibly, I know it's hard to say this, intimidated by four different ventilators that you have to learn how to run. You learn the basic concepts. They apply to any ventilator. One of the big things about being an RT is being able to adapt, pick up new pieces of equipment and figure them out, and also rig. We rig a lot of stuff. So pieces, parts, and adapters is what we do. So if you have enough pieces, parts, you can put anything together, and once you learn how to run a vent, you guys can run any vent. When I first moved out here, I'd worked in home care for 14 years, and I told you guys that. We used vents in home care, but they were different. So I hadn't seen these new ICU ventilators. So when I came in here, I had to do the same thing that you guys are going to have to do. I had to figure out how to turn them on and where all the buttons are, and you'll see that I know all that now because I know how to run a vent. So the same thing will apply for you. So We're gonna learn how to turn each one on, where the different sections are. We'll just learn the names and some of the things that are different. So as you go forward and new equipment is introduced to you, humidifiers do the same thing, they just look different. They're both here to humidify the air that's going to the patient. They both have two ports. They both have wires. So the way the wires work, and this is for almost any set of wires, is you're gonna have a part that plugs in to the actual heater. Oh shoot, of course this is not the ones that we want. Does anybody see a pair of orange wires down there? One of those? And what you're gonna find is you have a short wire and a long wire between the two. On your circuit, you have a hole up at the top, which if this is hooked to your ventilator, this is far away, so the long wire goes down there of the two. So see, one's long, one's short. So the long one's gonna go down in here, and then the short one goes down here, like so. Any place where there's holes, they either have to be plugged closed or you have to have something in there to keep air from leaking out. We're gonna hook wires up because almost every hospital uses heaters, and I want you to learn how to hook the wires in because it's a little complicated. It's not super complicated, but it's a little intimidating at first. And then keep in mind that this would plug into the heater if you had it. It's the way to connect it. You're not gonna do that here, so this piece is just gonna hang, because it doesn't fit into this heater. It's just a set of wires. Just like putting the base on there, you can hook it into the bottom of the heater. That's where it would go if it was hooked in. Knowing where all these wires go is what's important. This part will already be there when you go work at your hospital. So that's one set. The other set front, these ports are blue at the end instead of orange. And so this long one is gonna go into here. Same spot, just a different cord. And then this short one, this is what this one looks like, goes into the area down there. So this one goes in, and you guys will see when you see it up close, there's a little tab here, and it actually, this is not in all the way. That little blue tab has to be snapped all the way down into place. And when you take it out, you're actually twisting it. You're gonna twist it like that. It's not gonna break, it's fine. So push it in so that the little blue part on the side is going underneath that, and that secures it into place, like so. And to undo it, twist it and pull it out, okay? So again, it doesn't matter that the wires look different, you're gonna do the same thing. It's just a different brand of wires. The other end of these would hook into, if you have the heater, it hooks into here. They're yellow and blue, and they go right into the side, yellow and blue. And I'll show you because you're going to want to know where these other cords go. And as you guys get your hands on, this will make more sense. There's also connectors at the end of these hoses that is unique to this humidifier itself, where these will go in. They have shapes and they only fit one way. The problem is the pins are bent in them. Circuits are meant to be used one time with one patient, and we use them multiple times. Even if we only used them a couple weeks, the pins bend. So they won't fit in there, but if you're in the hospital, that will go there, and that will go there. These parts for the wires, there's no holes underneath there, so if you just let them hang, that's fine. The other parts, there's holes, they can't hang, they have to actually be in, okay? And again, you would just let those hang. So that's where the wires go. Now on our actual vent circuit, we have inspiratory and expiratory. This one happens to be color-coded, but they're not all color-coded. So you have to know inspiratory and expiratory by this port right here. The circuit limb with the heater port on it is the inspiratory one. We're checking the temperature on the air going to our patient. That's the side without the port on it is the expiratory one. Because they're not all blue and white. Some are all blue, some are all white. So if I ask you which side is inspiratory, you can't tell me the blue side. You have to show me by the one that has the port. Then the other thing we have to do is actually hook it up on the ventilator.
You said the side with the port is inspiratory?
Yes. So this is the last part that goes with every vent, and then I'll get specific with the PB. So when we hook up a circuit, we have inspiratory and expiratory on our ventilator, and there's going to be some way that that's identified on your vent. On the Puritan Bennett, you see the words to patient and an arrow pointing out. That's inspiratory. Sometimes you'll see INSP. That's inspiratory. Sometimes you'll just see an arrow pointing out from the ventilator. If this is the vent and the arrow points that way, that means it's going to the patient. If this is the vent and the arrow points in, that means it's coming back from the patient. So now we have to hook this up right so that inspiratory is hooked to inspiratory. So any vent hooks up this way. You have two, basically you guys, this is just two pieces of corrugated tubing. If I had to make a circuit, I could make a circuit with two pieces of corrugated tubing and a little Y piece in a worst case scenario, and we've done it before. So, but now I need to hook all this up. So if you want to think about the way the air is going to go, we're going to get air going from the ventilator. It's got to go to the water, pick up water to humidify the air. That's going to go to the patient. And then once it gets to the patient, it's going to come back to the vent. So the inspiratory side has always got to hook through the water chamber. Same thing on this one. If it was the cylinder, you would just hook it to the cylinder instead. From the vent to the water, from the water to the patient, so the inspiratory side, and then from the patient back to the ventilator, to the expiratory side. So you always got to pay attention to make sure which one's inspiratory and which one's expiratory. So like I said, the PB840 says to patient. So if you're going to hook it up without a heater, which you might do every once in a while, it's not very common. If you were going to hook it up without a heater, you would just take your inspiratory side, the one with the port, and hook it directly there. We're going to use this, though, because we want to pick up water. The other thing that goes, and this will vary depending on where you're at, is how filters are used. Here, we put them on both sides. There's an inspiratory and expiratory filter. They both look exactly the same. So we're just going to filter the air before it goes to our patient. So I'm going to put a filter there first, and then I'm going to take this short hose, which is in the bags on the ventilators. And you're going to take the short hose and hook it on the inspiratory side of the vent and go from the vent to the water and then from the water to the patient. So my inspiratory side goes next. Like that. And then hook up a test lung, which you need. And then from the patient back to the ventilator on the expiratory side. The PB840 specifically has this filter right here. If it's any other vent, we put one of those white filters on that side. The PB has its own filter, filters out any moisture that can collect down here. There's also a little blue little switch right here. This lifts up. You can take the filter out, replace it. They do get cracks and things in them. So if you're doing troubleshooting, that's one of the things sometimes you'll have to be replacing. And then it just slides back in. And this piece must be locked in place or the ventilator will not work. So it's very important that that has to be locked in. There's a seal up there that you'll learn about in a couple weeks. And if that's not locked in, it doesn't seal off and it won't cycle from inspiratory to expiratory. So any ventilator, doesn't matter which ones we're using or which heater we use, short hose on a filter goes to the water. Then the inspiratory side, which is the side with the port, goes from the humidifier or the water to my patient, which for our purposes in here is our blue lung. And then it's going to go from the patient back to the expiratory side of the ventilator. Okay? Make sense? All right. So let's go into specifically now on the PB. And remember, if you don't have a heater base, what are you going to do? Just let it hang. You're always going to hook up heaters in here because you have to learn how to do that. So if this was part of your midterm, this is the first part that you gotta do. You gotta get all this hooked up. And you could have this kind or this kind, so you must get familiar with all of them. So we've got